We are talking about the earworm, a common affliction for which there is no known cure. Listen up to Mark Mullen, If You Dare.
It only takes a second for a song to creep in, but it can take hours, sometimes days, to shake it.
Like a virgin. Ooh!
Now there's a name for songs you just can't get out of your head. An earworm. In a recent study, David Kramer, a graduate student of cognitive science at Dartmouth College, found that earworm isn't an ear problem at all.
You have in your brain a stored representation of that song that you've heard before. Just hearing the song for whatever reason can sort of trigger that memory in your brain, and sometimes it'll continue to play.
Crazy!
Essentially, the auditory cortex acts as the brain's iPod, recalling familiar and sometimes unwanted musical memories.
It usually lasts all day.
But one ear's annoyance,
you can change it if you want.
I don't care, it's up to you.
Is music to another's bank account.
Don't you remember you told me you love me, baby?
If I could tell you what made some songs more contagious than others, I would be making a lot more money writing those songs. Frankly, that's the million-dollar question.
And radio isn't the only source of earworm infection. Marketers dream of getting one of their tunes stuck in your head.
I want my baby back.
But once you're hooked, how do you let go? There's only one known cure for this affliction, and it's not for the faint of heart.
When I think about you,
you know I want you.
For today, Mark Mullen.
Maybe because you love it.
Oh, man. NBC News, Los Angeles.